Coral reefs are the jewels of the ocean. They're magnificent structures created by corals over eons that support a wealth of other organisms. Unfortunately, corals are dying on many reefs across the globe. Some reef inhabitants, such as parrotfish, literally bite and scrape the reef in pursuit of algae that grow on top of corals, literally grinding down the reef in the process. So you'd think that being eaten would be bad for the reef.
So hi, I'm Dick Norris, and this is Katie Cramer from Scripps Institution of Oceanography. And it turns out our research in the Panama coral reef has shown exactly the opposite of this expectation that eating the reef would somehow be bad for it.
And unfortunately, parrotfish are increasingly rare on many Caribbean reefs due to overfishing by local communities. We teamed up with Aaron O'Day from the Smithsonian Tropical Research Institute to collect reef sediment cores in Panama. We wanted to understand what reefs looked like thousands of years ago before humans began fishing on them.
So we collected these cores and we split them open and you look inside and they have what looks kind of like concrete. It's a mixture of little pieces of coral and the remains of all the other animals that lived in the coral reef, including the teeth of parrotfish. Next, we took pieces of that coral and we used high-precision uranium-thorium methods to actually give us an idea of how old the coral was through our coral cores. And then the last phase was very laborious, hundreds of hours spent hunched over a microscope, picking these tiny little parrotfish teeth out of the reef sediment so that we could figure out how many parrotfish there were as the reef was growing.
We found that the more parrotfish there are on the reef, the faster the reef grows. We think this is because parrotfish eat algae that compete with the corals, and when you have too much algae on the reef, the corals die.
And the corals, in turn, of course, are what is growing the reef. So if they're in competition with the algae, then the coral reef as a whole won't grow very fast. But, of course, the parrotfish are keeping the algae in check, and so if you have a lot of parrotfish, you have a nice, healthy, growing reef.
So what do we conclude from our study? If we want to protect reefs and the diversity of organisms that depend on them, we have to protect the parrotfish from overfishing.
And indeed, many Caribbean nations have started to institute laws to protect parrotfish. But those laws need teeth. Actually, parrotfish teeth. Now, the cool thing for our perspective is that we can use our scientific results and take that to the local managers, the people who are involved in reef conservation, and give them the latest information on how they can go and protect their own reefs.
So thank you for watching. If you want to learn more about our Caribbean reef coring project and how we're using these sediment cores as a time machine to track how reefs have changed from the time of Columbus to the present, please check out our paper online.